With me here this morning from Blue Star Capital, I'm joined by Tony Fabrizi. Tony, good morning.
Good morning.
And Blue Star itself moving into the world of eSports. Tell me a bit more about these investments.
Yes. It's an exciting time for Blue Star. We've made an announcement this morning that we're investing in 6 eSports companies. Sort of global reach now. We've got investments in the UK, India, America, Canada, Singapore, and Australia. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we're very excited by the esports space. It's, you know, we believe it could be the fastest growing sports media market of all time. And the number of fans globally is amazing, and esports could be the biggest by 2022, more fans in esports than any other sport. Mm. So, you know, it's very, very exciting to get involved at an early stage in what we think is a, you know, great market.
Well, what more can you tell me about these businesses? Are they fairly young?
Yep, so we're very early stage. These are first round investments. Right. So our stakes are between sort of 11 and 14%. So they're quite chunky stakes, but we're getting in early. The opportunity has been presented to us by Jonathan Bixby, who was behind Argo, came to market last year, was, you know, pretty successful. And Jonathan's been looking at this space for a long time. We've been talking to him. And yeah, we're sort of investing alongside some of his investors and other people in 6 really quite, you know, early stage but exciting opportunities.
And the idea here, following these businesses with the intention of some regular news flow.
Yes, very, very important obviously is that we start getting some news flow out on Blue Star. We've been obviously criticized over the last sort of 6 months or so for not really getting much news out. Unfortunately, Satoshi Pay, which I'll come on and discuss later, has been a bit slower than we wanted in terms of its commercial traction. So I think this is going to be a nice complement to our portfolio. We're expecting a lot of news flow, and you know, hopefully that will start very soon.
Well, just while we're on the subject of Satoshi Pay, just why has it been a bit quiet on that front?
Yeah, I think it's a reflection of what's happening in the market generally, of cryptos and blockchain generally. So, I mean, obviously with Libra coming, being announced many months ago by Facebook, that's increased the scrutiny on the whole sector. And so you've got governments and regulators now taking a very serious look at this industry. And what that's meant is some of the corporates who are looking to perhaps move into this earlier, you know, they're perhaps taking a step back. And so I think some of the bigger companies that were likely to sort of move in early, you know, have decided not to, or wait and see what happens. And that's impacted Satoshi Pay. Obviously, some of its some of our potential customers for Satoshi Pay are quite large media companies globally. And you know, I think they are, you know, a bit more reluctant just to start that process. So I think it's going to be slower. And but it doesn't take away from the fact that I think it's a great company, and I think they will succeed. And in fact, today we've announced that they're going to move into the B2B payment space. Mm-hmm. That's a $160 billion market globally. It's competitive, but you know, they've done a lot of work looking at this sector, and they've got some good conversations ongoing with some decent players in that sector. And yeah, we're pretty optimistic we'll get some news flow there.
And they've had some significant strategic investment.
They have. So earlier this year, as you probably remember, we tried to reverse Satoshi Pay into Blue Star at the end of last year, and having got some very strong support initially, the markets came off at the end of last year, and you know, we just couldn't get that deal away. So Satoshi Pay raised some capital beginning of last year, $2.5 million. At a decent valuation, $15 million, and that was well supported by some Boston Media, a large German media business, and also some foundations. And you know, that means they've got plenty of cash, and they've been building up the technical side of the business over the last 6 months. So it hasn't been any news flow, but the business is developing, and you know, I'm hopeful we'll get some news flow later this year.
And this is still your largest investment?
Yes, it is. Yeah. So we invested $1.9 million in total. And the last valuation back in March, the external valuation, our stakes were $4.6 million. So it's quite a significant uplift. But unfortunately, the share price doesn't reflect that yet.
What about your biometrics payments business?
Yes, Starla, we made this investment 4 years ago. It was our first investment when I was sort of took on this role as CEO. It's done very well. We came in at $3 million. It's now valued at 30, although I think they're raising money at 40 now. It's doing very well. It still hasn't delivered commercially what we might have hoped, but there's a lot of interest in it from some very big sort of banks and commercial partners. And as I say, they're fundraising, they do seem to attract money because the opportunity is so big. Mm-hmm. If they get this right, it's a big company.
And it's been tough going for DTL?
Yes, unfortunately, we announced this morning DTL has continued to sort of suffer from some bad news. We have written it down significantly. This was an investment we inherited, the board inherited from the previous management. So it wasn't something we were involved in initially. It did look quite promising 2 or 3 years ago. One of their investments looked like it could do very well. But unfortunately, that hasn't happened. So you know, probably it's likely we're going to write it down further at the accounts.
But you feel this move this morning announcing the push into eSports, that's the right decision for Blue
Definitely.
Star?
I mean, I think some people maybe find it strange that we've made this investment given the state we have in Satoshi Pay. But I think the opportunity here is very large. I think it de-risks the overall portfolio. We're into 6 new companies in what we think is a fast-growing sector. The news flow is going to be, I'm sure, very good. And I think that will complement our 2 longer-term investments, which I think are Satoshi Pay and Starla. You know, I think they're sort of 2 or 3 year plays, whereas I think these businesses could be listed very quickly. I think there'll be a lot of activity.
And you're looking to raise up to 900,000
raise. Yes. So yes. So we've actually announced this morning a £450,000 unconditional raise. We had authority to do that, and then we have to go to a general meeting to raise the final 450, which will be sometime. That meeting will take place sometime the first week of November.
And you've taken part?
I have. Yes. I invested £20,000 in the placing. It's been done at a premium to the closing price on Friday, so it's 0.1. The price was 0.75 on Friday. Good demand for it. We've got some very good investors coming in this round, including potentially a new chairman, subject to regulatory approval. Derek Luz, based in Vancouver, got 20 years experience in small cap investing. And we're delighted Derek's been, you know, loves the story of Blue Star. He thinks it's very undervalued and, you know, he believes the eSports investments are a great opportunity. So he's put £100,000 into this round. And the other, I suppose, point to bring up today is the warrant issue that we've announced. So it's quite an aggressive grant of warrants, but a lot of those have been issued to Jonathan Bixby, who I mentioned, brought the deal to us. And Jonathan, if he invests the full amount, will be investing over £1 million in Blue Star over the next 18 months. So they're short-dated warrants. You know, he has to invest that money very quickly. And we think it means there's 1.3 million coming into Blue Star over the next 18 months. Mm. If all the warrants are exercised, which would be, you know, it gives us a lot of ammunition to carry on investing in these lovely companies.
And you own around 2%?
My investment after today's 20,000 is 2% of the company, yeah. I also have a warrant package as well as part of this announcement. So there's another 65 million warrants that I could exercise. Mm. So that would take my stake obviously up.
Tony, good to get an update. Nice to see you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Cheers.